guitar since I was 10, and I've just been singing all my life. But I also really love science. I really love chemistry, biology, and especially psychology. I just love understanding the math behind why things work the way that they do. So that's why when I got the opportunity to pick any subject in the entire world to spend the second semester of my senior year researching, I thought, what better than to bring these two worlds together? So that's why for my craft project, I researched how music works. Why do we like music? Why does it make us happy? Why is music good? But before I could answer this question, I had to tackle another question. What does good mean? So throughout my research, this question kept coming up over and over again, and I kept finding all these different definitions. And eventually it all came together into something else, but we'll talk about that later. First, we're going to focus on the different definitions of good that my research got split into. So, first definition, constants and distance. If you know anything about music, you know that constants is, you know what constants is, but for those of you who don't, it's essentially just harmoniousness. It's what, in my mind, separates music from random noise. Anything you hear, every sound, is just soundness. It's just the air vibrating, your eardrums vibrating, and then your brain processing that. But the difference between random noise and something that sounds like... something that sounds like that, in my opinion, is organization. Some people will call music organized sound. If you play a single note, that's a single frequency. Whereas if you do something like bang on the table or construction, it's going to be random frequencies playing at random times. But a single note, that's not consonant yet. It's not consonant, and it's not a harmony until you add other notes. That's a major chord. And every note in that chord can be is a single frequency. And each frequency can be graphed. It'll look something like that. So, if you look at this graph, you can see that all three of those lines actually line up pretty well. They all meet up at a specific point right at the end there. And if this graph were to keep going, it would keep meeting up over and over again. That's the organization piece of music. And that's one reason researchers believe music sounds so good. On the other hand, dissonance looks like this. Now you have lines that don't match up so well. They're, and if you play it on the piano, it's going to sound like this. Not so great, right? So the organization is what we believe makes music sound good. But is dissonance necessarily bad? Well, let's take those two notes again, and let's add this one and this one. Well, now we have... that sounds kind of nice, right? This is an E7 chord, and what's happening is we're adding context to the dissonance. Now it's not just two notes that clash, instead we have an E major chord with an added dissonant note. So now the dissonant note is making the chord interesting. It's adding something new to something we're familiar with. And then we can make it even more interesting by doing something like this. Does that make me crazy? Like, right? You guys are probably, yeah, sing the note for me. What comes next? Yeah, so that anticipation, when you set up those expectations, you know what's supposed to come next and you really want it to come. And then as a result, when it does come, it just feels that much better because that anticipation was prolonged. And once it's, you've built up a ton of tension, and once that tension is released, it feels really good. So in music, a really good example of this is Hallelujah by Leonard Cohen. So, for those of you who don't know it, I'll sing it really quickly. It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, and the major lift, the baffled king composing Hallelujah. And so on. So what's happening in this song? Well, we're starting on the C major chord. This is the home of the song. This is where the whole song is pulling from. Start here, and it's where it wants to end. As the song starts, we can feel it building up. And the emotion, the tension is starting to build up, and you're starting to wonder, how are we going to get home from here? All we feel is the up, 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 right? And it keeps building until we get to here. That same chord, that same E7 chord, the distance right in the middle. Except now it has even more tension than it did before. Now it has a note that is outside of the key that we're playing in. We're playing in the C major scale, but we're playing this note in the chord. So this chord is just filled with tension, and as the song builds up to this point, you're just thinking, how are we going to get home? How are we going to get home? All that tension has to be released somehow. But instead of being released, find ourselves here. And Leonard Cohen just refuses to bring us back home, keeps prolonging that anticipation. And as a result, when we finally do get home, it feels that much better, right? So I'm gonna play the song one more time. And think about what I'm talking about. Think about that tension, that buildup, and eventually the release. And maybe it'll sound a little different other times you've heard it.
Goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, and the major lift, the baffled king composing Hallelujah. Hallelujah,
just the same four chords over and over again. For instance, this one, 2107. I played that song for them and they thought, oh, that's a little repetitive. It's a little bit like every other pop song I've ever heard, basically. It was the same four chords over and over again. The lyrics were super general and basically could apply to almost any story. But when I sang it for the person who it was written for, she could barely get through a single verse before turning to me and saying, oh my god, every single line is just me. you just read my mind. How did you do that? She loved the song. She gave it a 10 out of 10. On the other hand, some songs were a little bit more musically complex. So this one starts out with four chords repeating over and over.